today we will petition our Daddy God and lay our supplications at His feet in reference to hidden agendas. Hidden agenda, a secret or ulterior motive for something. The scripture for today is coming from 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, and I'm going to be reading verses 2 through 8, and I'm reading in the Message Bible. Again, that is 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 2 through 8, Message Bible. This is Paul speaking. No hidden agendas. Let us go to the Word of God. God tested us thoroughly to make sure we were qualified to be trusted with this message. Be assured that when we speak to you, we're not after crowd approval, only God approval. Since we've been put through that battery of tests, you're guaranteed that both we and the message are free of error, mixed motives, or hidden agendas. We never use words to butter you up. No one knows that better than you. And God knows we never use words as a smokescreen to take advantage of you. Even though we had some standing as Christ's apostles, we never threw our weight around or tried to come across as important with you or anyone else. We weren't a loaf with you. We took you just as you were. We were not patronizing, never condescending, but we cared for you the way a mother cares for her children. We loved you dearly. We loved you dearly, not content to just pass the message. We wanted to give you our hearts, and we did. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 2 through 8, Message Bible. Let us go to the throne of grace. I will propose this question before I go to the throne of grace. How many of us can proclaim we are free from hidden agendas? Yes, who the Son sets free is free indeed. But there is no good thing that dwelleth in this flesh, and our flesh needs to be crucified on a daily basis. How many of us can proclaim we are freed from hidden agendas? Dear gracious and eternal Father, we humbly come to you at this time to just thank you, praise you, honor you, worship you in spirit and in truth this morning, Daddy God. First and foremost, Father God, we ask for the forgiveness of sin, Father God. Anything we may have thought, said, or done that was unpleasing in your sight, Father God. Father God, we ask that you would forgive us right now, Father God. We ask that you would create in us a clean heart, Father God. Renew a right spirit within us this morning, Father God. Sanctify our minds this morning, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father God. Father God, we ask that you would crucify this flesh this morning, Father God. For we know that no good thing dwelleth in this flesh, Father God. And this flesh needs to be crucified on a daily basis, on an hour basis, on a minute-by-minute basis, on a second-by-second basis, Father God. Because there is no good thing that dwelleth in this flesh. So continuously crucify this flesh in the blessed name of Jesus, Daddy God. Now we thank you, Father God. We thank you for another day of life. We thank you for tapping us on our shoulders and telling us to arise this morning, Father God. We thank you for another opportunity to be before your throne of grace, Father God. We don't count it lightly, Father God, that we are before your throne of grace, Father God. So we thank you for this opportunity, Father God. We thank you for the opportunity to get it right with our loved ones, Father God, whomever we may have trespassed, Father God. Father God, and we thank you, Father God, for giving us the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, Father God, to have a forgiving heart for those that have trespassed against us, Father God. Father God, we thank you this morning, Father God, for loving on us unconditionally, Father God, not based on condition, Father God, for we are not saved by our works, Father God, but it is only by your grace and your mercy, Father God. So, Father God, we thank you for saving us.
as God has already created someone to love on you. And have a wonderful, blessed weekend. Amen.